Hello and welcome to another update video about Cardano. In this video we're going to take a look at the Cardano chart and the Bitcoin chart, and we keep it brief. Not much has happened, but we continue our way to the downside in my opinion. As I said before, that is what I expect, and we start with the Bitcoin chart briefly. What we can see on Bitcoin here, it is struggling at the moment. You know, we had this triangle on the chart. I would have expected this to, well, to break out to the downside. Did say that as a bearish pennant. Now, if that already was a breakout, hard to say, because what you can see here on the 4-hour chart, that yes, we broke to the downside, absolutely we did, and this could now have been a retest. You know, you can see the red candle and the green candle, so that could have been a successful retest of the lower line here of that triangle, a successful retest of a as resistance, and we could now go down from here. Or will this be extended? You know, could this be a larger triangle or something? So that is too early to say, because we haven't seen the volume yet now, the sell-off volume. So it could really be become something like an extended triangle here or so. So anyway, I expect further moves to the downside. I think this is part of a consolidation after a strong move down. You often get that, and there is still, in our 5-way move to the downside, the last leg to the downside is still missing. So I expect us to land in the area between 54 and 57k. This is the target area for that wave 4 based on the Elliott wave method and the Fibonacci retracements. So looking at Cardano doing basically the same thing that Bitcoin is doing as well. As we've said in previous videos, it is now starting really to follow Bitcoin. We can see that on the AWTC chart, broken out of the triangle to the downside here as well, a little bit stronger, but we have not come again into the yellow target range. You can see that this really is a key support level as well. Here, this 181 level, which is the golden pocket where we are finding support here. If we come below that, we will find support again, in my view, at the 233-day moving average at 178, before we then could come really lower in this target range. At a minimum or maximum, in my view, like worst case scenario for me is 145, again, before we then continue our move up. That is my expectation. You can have a different opinion. That's my expectation, and I base that on the Elliott wave counts and the just the rules applied basically by the Elliott wave method. So this is all I do, applying the rules here. No hype or anything, that is what they tell me. So really don't understand some of these comments that I sometimes see in the chat here. You know, people talking about Cardano being a stable coin, which is rubbish, because it's made like over 1000% in you know, I would need to look it up how much it really was, but it was over 1000%, I think, in a year or whatever. So it's crazy, and I mean, it will go up from here. I mean, that is my view, and that's what the counts tell me. Based on the Elliott wave rules, it will go up from here. So there isn't really anything else I can say about that. No other conclusion I can come to, really. So that is what it is. And to be honest, the 233-day moving average was a really good support here. So maybe we'll come down to that, even if Bitcoin drops to that 54 to 57k range. Maybe that support will really hold, that 233-day moving average, which is at 178. AWTC continues again, confirmed. You know, when I said in the previous video, we continue to stay in this bullish pattern in the descending wedge. We continue our bullish divergence here on the RSI so far, and you can see how interesting, actually, how we are finding resistance at the 50 line here on the daily. No, this is the 4-hour RSI. But on the daily AWTC, we can see a very similar picture, that we are going up here on the RSI. It just takes a moment to load. Yeah, and we're getting closer to the 50 line as well. So at some point here, we will shortly see that turnaround where then Cardano will outperform Bitcoin. That is my view. At the moment, that's what I can see in the charts. And yeah, I personally also hope it will happen, because Cardano is one of my biggest holdings. So hope you liked this update about Cardano. If you did, please smash the like button and subscribe. Thanks a lot for watching. Bye bye.